Hello, I'm today here on the AWE fair in Munich, the fair for augmented reality and virtual reality. And I'm here with Ori Inbar, the founder of this fair. And he is here on this fair in Munich the third time, and the fourth time is it really in Germany. Here it is very loud in the hall, so we go outside, then we can speak a little bit more with more quiet. And the AWE, the idea of the AWE is a little bit more old. You started 10 years ago with the first AWE in US.
That's right. Mm-hmm. 2010 was the first AWE. Just a small group of people getting together to discuss the vision of what AR could be. And now it's actually becoming something that many corporations and consumers are using. Mm-hmm.
And why was this your idea to start the AWE? Because this is not so easy to decide, I will make a fair.
So I started a company, a startup, in 2008 that developed AR games. And we were trying to get together with other entrepreneurs in this space. But there was no event, so we said, let's start our own event. Mm-hmm. And that's how the first AWE happened.
So this is 10 years ago, and in Germany you started in Berlin, the first fair in 2016. How much exhibitors were in this fair?
So in the first year in Germany we had about 40 exhibitors, and that was like and about 800 attendees, and now we obviously are at about 100 exhibitors and nearly 2,000 attendees. So it's really grown together with the market and together with the adoption of the AR and VR in Europe.
So yeah, this year the hall was very, very full. And for me, it was also very interesting because I've had the chance to see the first HoloLens 2. And 2 years ago when the HoloLens started, it was not so really for me that the augmented reality is really mass market at the stage. But what do you say, is augmented reality at the right time now for the mass?
I think it is. If you look at the adoption of corporations of AR, over 70% of all Fortune 1000 companies are interested in either deploying or planning to deploy it in the next year. And that is because it's showing improvement in the bottom line. You know, they save time and money, and it's just worth the investment.
And is it only with the glasses, the augmented reality, or is it more than use it with the glass, with the lens?
So, you know, today we're seeing hundreds of millions of people using AR on their smartphones. Everyone has a smartphone that is capable of, you know, experiencing AR, and we're seeing it people using it for face filters, you know, with Snapchat or Instagram, which is kind of just for fun, but also using it for e-commerce, to buy things. So you can try before you buy, whether it's your makeup or some glasses on your face, or maybe it's trying a sofa in your home before you buy it. We're starting to see people using it more and more often and getting used to the idea. And I think once they try it on a smartphone, they will want to see it also on their smart glasses later on once it hits the mainstream.
So you think the next AWE in Munich will be with more than 200 exhibitors, or what do you think, what is your prognosis for the next year?
I don't have predictions for next year yet. I think we'll definitely see some growth, at least as much as the whole market is growing, which is about 30% a year. So I think we'll see that growth at least. But it really depends on you know what's happening here in Germany and in Europe, whether more companies are adopting it and more consumers are adopting it.
Do you think that you next year also will be in Munich? Or will it be Berlin again?
Yes, next year will be in Munich. We already booked the space here for next year.
Is Munich more interesting for the market than Berlin?
So Berlin was really fun, and there were a lot of startups there. So the startup scene is very energetic. But we didn't have enough of the big clients that are what the exhibitors are looking for. And everybody told us that Munich is a much better city for that. And that proven to be correct. We have here representations from all the, you know, major manufacturing companies in Germany and large corporations that are coming here to check out what software and hardware is sold. So in that sense, Munich is, although it's, you know, a bit more expensive, it's proven to be a much better location for this event.
Yeah, Munich is sometimes a little bit problem with the prices. So, somewhat for your time before, you told before that you developed an RI game in 2008 and before, what you made before?
So my background is in software startups, as a developer and a kind of manager of internet, some of the first internet applications in the 90s. One of the startups I worked for was acquired by SAP in 2001 for $400 million. So I spent then 7 years at SAP as a senior vice president responsible for the strategy for the new internet platform. It was called NetWeaver. And then decided to leave and go back to my roots in startups. Mm-hmm. And that's when I discovered augmented reality. Mm-hmm. I was blown away by this technology. I felt like this is my mission for the next decade or two to help bring it to the mainstream.
So this was the right decision to go in this new market, which is now on the beginning, on the start of the mass market. And I wish you good luck with the next AWEs in the next years.
Yeah, I mean, listen, it was, I thought it's going to happen much faster than it did. But I have to say that I really enjoyed every second in the last 10 years, both as an entrepreneur running my company and also kind of helping build the ecosystem with AWE. And also in the last few years as an investor in AR, early stage AR companies.